Friends, in this video, we will see voltage to current converter, which is also known as V2I converter. So, V2I converter is a circuit in which the load current, that is output current, is proportional to input voltage. That is, voltage is converted into current. As its name is V2I converter or voltage to current converter, we can see that here, V is our input and I is our output. It means that we are giving some voltage as an input and we are converting it into the current. And that's why its name is voltage to current converter. And here we have written that the load current IL is proportional to input voltage V in. Here you can see that this is our independent quantity. And this is our dependent quantity. Therefore, if this V in changes, this IL will change. The V to I converter has two types. The first one is V to I converter with floating load, and the second one is V to I converter with grounded load. Both these are classified on the basis of the position of load. The first one is V2I converter with floating load. As its name indicates, the load resistor is floating. Here the name is floating load. It means that the load resistor is floating. This is the circuit for the V2I converter. You can see that the input is applied to the non-inverting terminal and inverting terminal is grounded. Therefore, it is nothing but non-inverting amplifier. Here we'll assume that the load current is IL. This is our load resistor from which we are measuring the current IL, and this is our input current II. Let it is II. Now you can see that the load resistors, instead of saying it as a feedback resistance, we are saying load resistance. This is load resistance which is connected as a feedback resistance, and it is not connected to ground, and as it is not linked to ground, it is called as floating load. The feedback voltage is determined by the load current and it is in series with the VD, that is the differential voltage. And therefore, we can say that it is also, this circuit is also known as current series negative feedback amplifier. Now, applying KCL at node B, you can see that this is a incoming current and this is outgoing current. So II is equals to IL. Now II is our input current and IL is the load current, that is output current. The value of II is given by VB minus 0 upon RI. So we can simply write VB upon RI is the value of II, but we will not explain the value of IL here because we need IL in our equation. We have to prove that IL is proportional to VIN. So we are just converting II here as VB upon RI into IL. Now it is a non-inverting amplifier, so applying virtual ground concept, VA is equals to VB equals to VIN. We will put VB equals to VIN in this equation. So our equation will be VIN upon RI is equals to IL, or IL is equals to VIN upon RI. Here you can see that this RI is constant, therefore IL is directly proportional to V in, and hence our equation is proved here. Now the second type is V2I converter with grounded load. Now you can see that this is our load resistor RL, and the current flowing through this is IL, and it is connected to ground, and that's why its name is V2I converter with grounded load. Now applying here, we can apply let this point be A, and we can apply the KCL at this point. And applying KCL at point A, these two are incoming current, that is I1 is incoming and I2 is also incoming current, whereas IL is our outgoing current and IB is also our outgoing current, but IB is equals to 0, therefore I1 plus I2 is equals to IL here. Now we will replace the value of, now we will write these currents in the form of voltage, and we will not change the IL, it will remain as it is, as we have to prove that IL is proportional to Vin, therefore IL will remain as it is. So I1, here we can calculate the value of I1, the direction of I1 is this one, therefore this voltage, that is Vin minus VA upon R is I1. Similarly, I2 has direction from VO to A. So VO minus VA upon R is the equation for this, and IL is as it is. Now, as it is having the same denominator, we can write V in, now minus VA minus VA will get added and it will become minus 2VA plus V0, that is VO upon R is equals to IL. This is our equation number 1. Now we have to find out the value for VA, that is the voltage at the non-inverting terminal, and it is given by, we know that for a non-inverting amplifier the output voltage is given by VO is equals to 1 plus RF upon RI into V in. Now 1 plus RF, this is feedback resistance, it is having value R, upon RI is also having the value R, therefore it is 1 plus R upon R into VA. Instead of using V in, we are considering the voltage at this point is VA, so it is equals to VA. V in is equals to VA. So 1 plus R upon R will be equals to 1 plus 1, that is 2, and therefore VA is equals to VO is equals to 2VA. Now put this VO is equals to 2VA in our equation number 1, and therefore we will get V in minus 2VA. Now it is plus VO, therefore it is plus 2VA upon R is equals to IL. Now this is minus 2VA and this is plus 2VA, this will get cancelled, and therefore IL is equals to V in upon R. Now again this is our constant, and we can write IL is proportional to V in, that is load current is directly proportional to input current. Now we'll see the applications of voltage to current converter. The first application is Zener diode tester, then low AC and DC voltmeter, then it is used in testing the diodes and testing the LEDs. Here you can see the diagram for this, and you can see here, let it is a diode D, it is connected here from output to input, and if we apply some input voltage, a constant input voltage, definitely a constant current will flow through this, because we are having formula IL is equals to V in upon R here and RI here. So a constant current will flow through this, and depending on that we can check the current flowing through the diode. If we are using LED here, so we can test the brightness of LEDs with the constant current flowing through it, because here again the current flowing through this diode will be constant, and thus it is used for testing diode as well as testing LEDs. Thank you.